Good afternoon. It's 1:55, 12:12, 20:30, and I haven't had any sun in my neck of the woods for about 5 days. It's been cold and rainy, and I'm feeling a lot better, and I've taken the time out to take some more notes, some more very, very important notes. Since our lives have been a puzzle and a lot of us are deprogramming. So this is for you people who have been listening to me and who don't think I'm a heretic and who don't think I'm a counterfeit and who don't think I'm lying about the things that I've suffered and endured and been through. Also, I want to let the people know that the patriarchs, the Eastern patriarchs, the Orthodox, this video is mainly for them to put some clarity on a situation that I spoke of a few videos back concerning the 24 elders and the, how the earth has been seeded. And there's a lot of disinfo and lies concerning the races and who seeded the races and how they came about. And my 5 days of no sun in my room, trying to feel better and taking some of the antibiotics that I've taken, I thought about a lot of things. And I want you people to understand that I have been hooked up to some type of artificial intelligence or supercomputer or MRI, and none of this information is coming through from this MRI. I mean, from this, what am I saying, MRI? From this AI computer. Because they don't want me to have no kind of information. This is my mind having to go into deep meditations to be able to figure out the lies that they have been trying to feed my brain, and me having to come up with the right conclusions about certain things because of us being under this heavy mind control. So also, I wanted to let y'all know about the Melchizedek order. A lot of the New Agers and their very old souls are part of that order, the Melchizedeks, or the free spirits. And they have a lot of knowledge, a lot of ancient knowledge. And they have been considered somewhat of New Agers, but they're not really New Agers. They're ancient ones. They're old ones. And they stayed out of religion. They did. They haven't gotten themselves involved in any religion. And they have been very helpful and sending me very healing and wonderful energy, and I want to thank them. But this video is mainly for the Middle East. And I want to talk about Arya, or the Armenians, and this cradle of civilization in Abraham, because when you start something at a point, it goes full circle. Ara means high. So I did some little research and I found out, why is it that I see this constellation in the sky sometimes at night? I am able to see whole star constellations, people. And Ara is a star constellation. And when I thought about that, the Armenians, and they call them the wandering Armenians and the Armenian curse. Well, I began to realize that Ara are the progenitors of that civilization, of the Abrahamic covenant, those wonderful beings, light beings of Ara. A-R-A. So I'm naming this video Ara equals High Altar of the Stars of Abram below Middle East glory of the faithful. And this is, we're going to go all the way back to the Eastern First Church of Antioch, founded by St. Peter and by St. Paul. So it began there in the honor of the Son of Man. The Orthodox churches shall be honored as the new body of Christ is formed in individuals. I see what the Templar and Malta Knights have done to the issue of believers. They've stole their heritage and their birthright. And I want to refer to Isaiah chapter 17 because it talks about Damascus and Syria being destroyed and desolated. And I think this Bible code was playing out to destroy that region. And that doesn't have to be. That prophecy does not have to happen at all. Because they are the ones to bless this planet. They are the high ones and the holy ones. And I want to also make a point to say, have y'all become ashamed of the rock mass of offenses I have become? A miksha, or a miksho, which is a stumbling block behind the esoteric mind tampering. I have become like Tamar, the two Tamars in the Bible. One of them was David's daughter. Actually, she was the only daughter he had. And Judah's daughter-in-law, Tamar, who married his brother, his sons, and none of his sons gave her any children, so she played the harlot. And she bore a son to their father, Judah. She bore twins, actually. So I've had to play the harlot. And this brings me to showing them that because of that, all those that were against me and came up against me, how Tamar proved more righteous than Judah because of what she had to do to remain faithful to the Most High and a keeper of the law and the covenants. So it started in Antioch, the first church. St. Peter and St. Paul. And there it will begin again to set matters straight. And what Peter said, because Peter was the founder of the church, he was the rock. And he was given that key. It said not even the gates of hell would be able to prevail over Peter the Rock. So I just wanted to let y'all know about some of my musings for the past few days on some very deep things. So Arah equals the high altar of the stars of Abram. Below, Middle East glory of the faithful, and the cedars, the big trees of righteousness of the East. I want to thank people, I want to thank all of you for not judging me, because I am not judging any, just because I made the comments about the gay community. I'm not here to judge them, and I don't approve of the lifestyle, but it's not for me to judge, and I have become aware of how the migration of people has happened now, how they've hidden history, how they've lied to us concerning our heritage, and may the Armenians not be a wandering people again, a wandering race. May they reclaim their homeland, the indigenous people of Mesopotamia. And so, may the indigenous Indians of North America reclaim their homeland and their heritage. So be at peace, people. Things will be worked out, and they're being worked out now. And everyone have a blessed day today. Because I've come to realize a lot of things under a lot of pressure. But there is nothing impossible with God. Remember that.